Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Peace be upon his messenger and his folk. Ladies and gentlemen, peace be upon you. We meet together today to recall a brother who was in the recent past a big brother, a man who was a strong person, who was very passionate and very loving to the UAE. He was a real patriot. He took the cultural action to high skies, and he took the cultural enterprises and the project to high levels. He planted seeds of culture, love, and fraternity. We start our event today with the national anthem of the UAE.
The
death of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui was very saddening to our hearts, but we all cannot say no to destiny. All we can do is to ask forgiveness and mercy to the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. We now leave the floor to the reciter, Sheikh Abdullah Al-Brimi, to recite few verses of the Quran.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Inna lil-muttaqin mafazan hadaiq wa a'naba وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا صدق الله العظيم.
هل من رثاء لائق؟
Is there any theology that can cure my injury? Is there any cure that can take out these words that were penetrating my heart? You said farewell to us, to your friends, to your family, and we had nothing but to cry, but our cries cannot bring you back. We meet together today to recall some tributes and attributes and characteristics of the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. He left in our hearts good memories. Anyone of us who has the opportunity to deal with the late Muhammad closely witnesses his noble manners. Now we give the floor to His Excellency Dr. Jamal Sanad Al-Sawidi, Director General of the Emirates Center for Research and Strategic Studies. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, Your Highness Sultan bin Tahnoon Al Nahyan, the President of Abu Dhabi Authority for Tourism and Culture, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, in this day, we all stand with grief and sorrow in memory of the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui, the big loss we inflicted in the country, in our cultural literature and heritage panorama. We proudly ink the profile of Muhammad. We are witnesses of his strenuous effort, his giving and innovation throughout the last two decades. In the cultural media and heritage march of the UAE, he had a primary role in founding the Millions Poets Competition. And also he had a role in the Prince of Poets competition and the International Hunting and Equestrian Exhibition and other cultural and heritage activities in addition to his leadership responsibilities. We were all contemporaries of the late Muhammad. We dealt with him closely and saw him contributing to the glittering prosperity of the UAE at national, Gulf, and international levels, and introducing at the same time his vision to the current and future generations and the height that the UAE should climb in the areas of culture, poetry, literature, media, equestrian hunting, etc. He was so keen to make Abu Dhabi, our beloved city, an Arab cultural capital in implementation of the directives of His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the President of the UAE, and His Highness General Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces. If we are to present a eulogy in his memory today, we put it in a nutshell and say Muhammad is present among us today and every day. His fragrant memory is widespread everywhere. May Almighty Allah bestow His mercy upon you and grant us and his relative friends patience and fortitude. Peace be upon all of you. Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui loved his country unlimitedly, and he translated that love into preserving the material and immaterial heritage and enhance it and renovate the fortresses and a lot of historical monuments in the UAE. Let's now watch a documentary that was produced by the Emirates Center for Research and Strategic Studies.
Thank you.
it's not unusual to Zayed House in the land of the UAE to give birth to the likes of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. He was a model man for loyalty to his country and nation. I find no more accurate expression to describe our relation to history, but to say we are our history. Everyone among us represents that patrimonial, cultural, intellectual, and social heritage. It's what we will leave behind for our grandchildren and children. The profile and register of the late Muhammad is full of intellectual, national, and patrimonial and patriotic positions and stances. He was known for his slogan, loyalty, then loyalty, then loyalty to the motherland and the leadership. That was reflected in high projects and initiatives that are based on national values and priorities derived from the UAE heritage and derived from the unified destiny and roots. Muhammad will remain in our heart with his words, with his deeds. Whenever we have new festivals and occasions, the name of Muhammad resurrects. And I think that it's very difficult to have likes of him. His name is unforgettable in the history of the UAE, and he coined his name in the history of the UAE and engraved that name. Al-Mazrui held several positions in his career in culture, heritage, and in every position he was a model for the ambitious man who believes in destiny, and he was so optimistic, and he was believing in the leadership, in the future, and the heritage, the rich heritage, and the high values and ideals of the UAE. And he was setting his sights on solidifying the position and reputation of the UAE, and Abu Dhabi in particular, as the capital of the Union. The late Abu Khalaf uttered last word in the Camel Festival, and that was one day before the National Day. He stressed on the fact that the flag of the nation should always stand high, and we have to be always proud of our nation, of the prosperity of our nation. And that was per se reflecting the spirit of Abu Khalaf, dedication, devotion, and commitment for the sake of the motherland. He was present in every service given to the nation, and he was in the front line, and he was standing against everyone who aims to offend or abuse our national values. He was not opening his house only to people, but he was opening his heart to people. He was ready to receive anyone, to listen to any problem from any person, and engages in helping others and serving them, even if he doesn't know them. He was fond of helping others. The achievements of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui during the past 10 years or so many. I think that he delivered what others can't deliver in centuries. He introduced a package of cultural enterprises and projects to Abu Dhabi, and this project will be eternalized in history and recorded in the history of the UAE. This project made Abu Dhabi a brand name, a city of a high reputation, a capital for culture and heritage through his several initiatives. He was challenging a lot of obstacles. There are a lot of initiatives that he did. He had always put the interest of the country of the UAE in the first place. Mohammed Abu Khalaf held several positions. He held the position of advisor for culture and heritage affairs in the court of Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. He was also a member in the board of Abu Dhabi Authority for Tourism and Culture. He also held the position of Director General for Abu Dhabi Authority for Culture and Heritage, which is the entity responsible for preserving the heritage of Abu Dhabi and UAE in general. He presided and chaired a lot of management committees of festivals and cultural and heritage programs, and he was a major actor and contributor to the success of many cultural and heritage activities and events. And this event, the success of this event was recognized by many worldwide. He achieved a lot of things. He made a radical change in the UAE cultural panorama, and also in the Arab and international cultural panorama. Part of this achievement was the launching of Abu Dhabi Equestrian and Hunting Exhibition, which he managed to shift it from a local event to an international event that attracts a lot of people. The profile of Mazrui is rich and full of programs like the Millions Poets, which is one of the leading programs in Nabati poetry, and also the Prince of Poets, which leads the programs related to classical Arabic poetry. That man left a fingerprint, a big fingerprint, that was reflecting his enlightened mind and his extrovert thinking, and this cultural, high cultural spirit, which links between intellect, thought, practically and theoretically in a very beautiful way. Who was thinking that there will come a day where we can produce two giant programs for poetry and lift high the flag of UAE and lift high the reputation of Abu Dhabi? Millions Poets, Prince of Poets, these two programs reflect the genius power of that man, because it is in reality attracting masses of audiences everywhere in the Arab world. The program of Millions Poets is a great cultural popular event emanated from the heart of Arab Peninsula, and it spread all over the Arab world. It was from the heart and enriched the hearts of the audiences. That person was the engine behind this project. That project realized a lot of achievements in terms of changing the social tissue, in terms of exteriorizing the talent of UAE, which were buried in trivialities and in the darkness. Now we see the media, and we see this pay of attribute to poetry. This program regained us some notions and perceptions which we absorbed since our childhood. There are some cultural inputs that attacked us from every corner, like satellite TVs, external cultures, etc., that made us far from our original roots, and such programs made us come back to our roots and originality and authenticity. All the indicators show that he succeeded by excellence in making lots of dreams a reality. During less than 2 years, Abu Dhabi Authority for Culture and Heritage, under his leadership, was starred and shined in the sky of Abu Dhabi through several projects in arts, culture, heritage, sports, like Abu Dhabi Film Festival and New York Film Academy, Abu Dhabi, and Sheikh Zayed Book Award, and tunes from the Orient and the Kalima Project, and Abu Dhabi Classical Music Festival, Liwa Date Festival, and Al Shara Program, and the bilingual magazine Ashawate, and the journal The Millions Poets, and also the Arab Oud House and Abu Dhabi Art. All those added a significant value to the cultural panorama of Abu Dhabi, and also not to forget the Abu Dhabi International Book Fair, which was leveraged to a very high level. A lot of achievements that we see and touch nowadays reflect the thinking of Boukhalif, like the cultural festivals such as Shara Program, the Millions Poets, this program which are broadcast in Abu Dhabi TVs reflect his interest in heritage and in showcasing the heritage of the UAE, like Camels Festival, Al Dhafra Festival, Liwa Dates Festival, and also the National Operetas. He was so keen to showcase the local and heritage music of the UAE to others and to utilize that music in the National Operetas. Mohamed Khalaf is really a very rare case in management, and when he was assigned the management of Abu Dhabi Authority for Culture and Heritage, he found an empire of culture and heritage. He exported culture and heritage, and he was so keen to show to others the UAE popular heritage and patrimonial heritage. Whenever the name of Mohamed Khalaf is mentioned, his achievements are mentioned as well, like his efforts in preserving and documenting the Emirati heritage, and here and with both material and immaterial types. He opened the Al Jahili fortress after restoration, and he turned it into a cultural minaret. He also encouraged the archaeological excavations and the restoration of historical monuments, and the project of gathering, of compiling the sources of written and spoken UAE culture. All these efforts led by Mohamed Khalaf through working to teamwork in a faithful way since 2010 resulted in registering the falconry as a human heritage internationally in the UNESCO in the representative list of the material and immaterial heritage. And also, thanks to him, we had Al Ain city registered as the first Emirati site in the list of material material heritage in UNESCO in 2011. He also led other initiatives as a chairman of Abu Dhabi Media, like founding the national newspaper, which was the first English newspaper to be issued from Abu Dhabi. Also, he was leading the initiative of National Geographic Abu Dhabi TV, and also the Abu Dhabi Media Summit, which gave a lot of people the opportunity and the chance to show their skills, especially local miracles and their presence and their contributions exceeded the expectations. May Allah bestow mercy upon you as a man, as an official, as a brother, as a friend, as a person. When you talk to him, you feel that he is an exceptional person in the fullest sense of the term. Everyone who mingled with that person or made an interview with him or worked with him feels that he is very distinguished. He has some charisma and modesty and unique presence. And he offered several services to Heritage and to the country of the UAE. If I spend 2 hours listing his manners and his contributions, I would not be able to finish and complete them. The model of Muhammad Khalaf is very unique. He is so distinguished in his thinking, in his planning, in the way he works with the working groups. Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui, when he was working with us, he gives you the impression that he is not your boss, but he is one of the executor of some assignment, of some task. He makes you feel close, and in some cases, you get the feeling that you work together with him like brothers and sister in the same house. And he doesn't make you feel that it is a task, but he makes you feel that it is a hobby that you love to perform and you love to practice. The life of the late Bukhalaf was full of good things. He contributed with his touch, with his fingerprints in the authority of culture and heritage. He developed a lot of things, and he also contributed to the development of the youth, the local youth in the UAE. Muhammad Khalaf is one of the many patriots in this country, first class patriot. Whatever we say about him, I think that we cannot complete listing his manners. He did everything with the support of our sheikhs. He did everything and he succeeded. They assigned him some positions, several positions, and he succeeded. He has many, and they cannot limit this achievement. We miss Sheikh Zayed and his likes, founders of the UAE sheikhs, a lot of them. And Muhammad is one of those who follow the path of the founders. And Muhammad Khalaf is in reality registered and engraved his name in the profile on the history of the UAE. And he put himself in a position that is very high, a position that his children and family should be proud of. And this role of serving the country and competing in serving the country, he was a model in that, in competing to serve the country. He was dealing with all people like brothers and sisters, those who were close to him and those who were far from him. He doesn't differentiate between the ones who know whom he knows and the ones whom he doesn't know. If somebody resorts to him for some service, like is sick, is debtor, or want to organize a wedding, or want to meet a sheikh or a sheikh or something, he used to tell him, just be patient, your request is entertained, and he smiles. So whenever he was either in the UAE or outside in Egypt, Libya, Tunisia, or any other country, he was easy to reach, he was easy to contact. It's why people were resorting to him. He was deserving that trust of Sheikh Khalifa and Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed. He's a real competent way, thanks God. Muhammad Bukhalaf is now with God. We ask Allah to compensate the Emirates. He had And he didn't have a declared will, but he used to say, if I die, shroud me with the flag of the UAE.
وجه السعد والمسرة والهنا نجمه أفل من سما الدنيا وغاب محمد الجود للا شنحنا يشل متنه يشل الثقيلها والصعاب محمد الجود للا شنحنا متنه يشل الثقيلها والصعاب واليوم نصفق عليه كفوفنا جل وقت.
This is a poem paying tribute to the soul of the late محمد خلف المزروعي.
عليك يا صاح حزن قلوبنا حزن المسقي على سيل الشعاب ذرى ذرية بغاطي بالجنا والموس مخلف سنا برقه وعاب أكبر خسارة علينا كلنا فراق زبن المجنة والركاب ننعاك والناس تنعى حظنا حجزت مقعد ذهاب بلا إياب والدهر كشر نيابه ضدنا من عقب ما انت قلعته.
May Allah bestow his mercy upon Abu Khalaf, who was a model for the values and achievements of the UAE. This is what nations need, and all nations looking forward or shooting or looking for Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. Charisma and the righteousness. Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui passed away very fast, and he left in our hearts an injury, and he left our hearts full of grief and sorrow. But we can say that he is present with us thanks to his achievement in serving the country and in serving the Arab world, from the Kalima project to Qalam, the pen project, and the millions poets and Arabic Poetry Academy, and the hunting and equestrian exhibition, and the date festivals. He was moving from one place to another, full of optimism, and he was competing with the time as if he was trying to achieve a lot in a very short time. Now we give the floor to the poet to recite some poetic verses in paying tribute to the late Muhammad al-Mazrui.
سمو الشيخ سلطان بن طحنون شكرا على الحضور.
Your Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Tahnoon, thank you for attending. Your Excellencies, thank you for attending. Dr. Jamal Sanad Swedi, thank you for gathering us here in this center, this great center for research and strategic studies. When a person feels that he is the one who has to give condolences and receive condolences at the same time, he gets he faces some obstacles which make him or her speechless. Sure that you share with me that everyone in the Arab world, in the intellectual and the cultural panorama, were sad because of the death of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. He composed this poem in the first spot, the first time, through the faces of the friends of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. The impressions they had in their faces were the ink of this poem. I didn't add anything to that poem after his death. So that was a first impression poem. It's why it's overloaded with grief and sorrow, but it was a very sincere and honest feeling.
حدقت في القلب يوم الضعن فانكسرا ما مت وحدك موتى بعدك الشعراء ما سرت وحدك لكن جزت موكبنا فكلنا في زحام الموت قد حشرا فكلنا في زحام الصف قد حشرا موتاهم الناس فوق الأرض قاطبة تحيا وتحت ثراها الصيت قد قبرا ناس على الأرض تمشي دون ما أثر وأجمل الناس يبقي خلفه الذكرى محمد الطيب لا أبكيك من فزع قد أيقظ الخوف في أعصابي الخدرا وارتد جمرا فهل ساندت أخيلتي أم أن حزن القوافي أيقظ الصورا كأنما الحب نهر في مسيرته يجري وينثر من أكمامه الشجرة أو أنه الغابة الصغرى وتتبعه ثقافة الحر كيما يحصد الظفرا والموت يا صاحبي مثل الصديق غدا يختار صحبته إن غادروا حضرا حدقت في الصحب لم أبصر سوى وجل وهيبة الموت فينا اغتالت الفكرا وغص بالريق قلبي مذ رأى خلفا بصمته لاذا أو في صمته استترى قد عشت بالأفق كالأقمار مرتفعا ونحن في اللحد جئنا ندفن القمر قد عشت في الأفق كالأقمار مرتفعا ونحن في اللحد جئنا ندفن القمر ما يوم دفنك إلا دفن فرحتنا فاغفر لكف تهيل الرمل والحجر وغص بالريق قلبي مذ رأى خلفا بصمته لاذ أو في صمته استترى قد عشت بالأفق كالأقمار مرتفعا ونحن في اللحد جئنا ندفن القمر ما يوم دفنك إلا دفن فرحتنا فاغفر لكف تهيل الرمل والحجر واغفر لحزن بدا خبأته خجلا كي لا تطيل على أحزاننا النظر وكان حزنك أن تلقى أخا حزن يستكتب الحزن أو يستنطق السيرا حتى إذا جاء مذعورا وثبت له كيما تقيل الخطى إن مال أو عثرا قد كانت الدار أغلى ما وصفت لنا وكانت الدار في تاريخك القدر أعطيت للدار ما أعطيت فاتحدت مشيئتان وحب قط ما فترى تذود عنها بما أوتيت من سعة في القول فيها بما من صدرك انهمرا وها رحلت عن الأصحاب مكتفيا بما قضيت بعمر مر واندثرا كأنما الموت صياد بمخلبه يمشي بعدته جهرا ومستترا وحط فوق بلاد الخير معطفه وخاط فيها كمينا يربك البشرا واختار بالحق من مالت قوادمه فصاد منا الثمين الماجد الحذرا لا أسأل الله إلا رحمة وسعت إلى الشقيق الذي قد أزمع السفر شكرا.
That was a poem delivered by the poet Karim Maatouq.
Mohammed Khalaf
Al-Mazrui was a model in good manners and intelligence. and smartness and dedication to serve the country thanks to his contributions and the likes of him. The UAE reached high levels and got recognized by many countries. Now we give the floor to Dr. Sultan Al-Amimi, director of the Arabic Poets Academy, Kalima. You have the floor. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, many thanks to the sheikhs attending, the journalists, ladies and gentlemen, and the family of Muhammad Khalif al-Mazrui. We greet Muhammad Khalif al-Mazrui. He is an omnipresent person. He cannot be absent because of death. Or the ones who live with us are really alive. There are several sayings that state that the real life is counted based on the achievement, not the period which documents the time of his birth till his death. A person like Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui remains alive in our minds. This country has a memory which doesn't forget people who sacrifice their time lives to Liwa region, to the sense of Liwa, which were honored to have Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui on its soil. To the Emirati culture doesn't forget those who take it high to the skies regionally and internationally. Poetry, two competitions, millions of poets, and the prince of poets, Academy of Poetry, cinema, film festival, music, media, different media, equestrian exhibition and hunting, date festival, Abu Dhabi International Book Fair, fortresses, museums, and national songs, operettas, and a lot of other cultural and art events. All these events know exactly who is Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui and what are the fingerprints he left. Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui was not a poet, was not a writer, was not a researcher, was not an artist, but he was a real man of culture, an intellectual who was faithful and loyal to his homeland, to all these types of art and literature. He was loving intellectuals, artists, and audiences of culture and art. This manners were embodied by the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. All people who worked with him know that a lot of achievements were realized thanks to him. His successes did not stop at any particular point, and we learned the lesson that the sacrifices and achievements given to the homeland should be limitless. He was a symbol of loyalty, of faithfulness, and we all saw that in reality he was loyal and faithful to those who worked with him, faithful to those who gave something to this nation, faithful to those who taught him something, faithful to his friends. He was always pointing to two manners. he considers important in order to be a good soldier for the homeland is loyalty and faithfulness. The availability of these two manners for him were not eligible for people only, but also in initiatives and cultural projects. He had a loving heart for his leadership, for the heritage of his nation. He was loving peace and tolerance. He was confident in putting trust in people working with him, and he was believing in institutionalization, that every success is a teamwork, is not the work of one person. And he was not keen ever to take the credit of any success that happens in the institution institutions he manages. All these manners of leadership and the attributes of leadership were main factors that led him to success. I remember that he was always, when he receives contact, when he was saying goodbye to them, he used to say, "I hope we remain together forever. We ask God to grant mercy upon him, and we ask God to make us patient to endure his loss." Our late was a model, an exemplary model for initiatives and the strenuous effort and dedication. He played a very important role in a very crucial stage in serving the heritage and the prosperity of the city. He was loving Abu Dhabi. He gathered poets from all over the world, and he had very good friendship with these poets. Now we give the floor to the poet, the Iraqi poet Abbas Jijan. Your Highness Sultan bin Tahnoon, Your Highness Muhammad bin Sultan, Dr. Jamal Sweedy, General Faris al-Mazrui, ladies and gentlemen, peace be upon you. Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui is my friend before he was my boss and line administrative manager. It's why it's difficult for me to tolerate his loss. During the past few weeks, I tried to overcome that loss, but it was so hard for me. So I share with you this poet in which I express my grief and sorrow and the difficulty I face to overcome such a great loss.
بس يعصن قراني أهدهن مثل خيل مقذلات بريح يطول المسافة وغيرنا يعاني صحيح أنا الغريب الما تعرف الناس بس أنا ذخر خرزة سليماني صحيح أنا الغريب الما تعرف الناس بس أنا ذخر خرزة سليماني أنا عصات موسى تبلع الآفات ودق له جرس للرأد الإنساني ما أبكي بدمع رغم ما أبكي بدمع من كثر بي هموم أنا ربيت حزني وحزني رباني وما أرثي صديقي وما أقلكم مات حتى على الهجر ما عود لساني ما أرثي صديقي وما أقلكم مات حتى على الهجر ما عود لساني أشوف بشاعر المليون قاعد راس وأنا خلف المستهل بالموقع الثاني أشوف بشاعر المليون قاعد راس وأنا خلف المستهل بالمقطع الثاني، وبعيد الوطن يرزف أبو خلوف، وبالظفر لقيت محمدي تاني، وبعيد الوطن يرزف أبو خلوف وبالظفر لقيت محمدي تاني، وبمزاين رطب لأهل الرطب نبراس، رطب دباس تمر خلاص بستاني، إماراتي من الجدم للراس، إماراتي لأن من الجدم للراس، يحب شيوخنا يحب شيوخنا وما عنده حب ثاني، إماراتي لأن من الجدم للراس، يحب شيوخنا وما عنده حب ثاني، علمنا أحب هذا الوطن للموت، وطن زايد فخر لو صار عنواني، علمني أحب هذا الوطن للموت، وطن زايد فخر لو صار عنواني، لا تعتب عليه لما نصيح بصوت، هذا الصوت من أعماق وجداني، محمد صاحبي وقط ما محمد صاحبي وقط ما قطع وياي، شايني على كفه شموع بصواني، وما حسيت بالغربة أبد والله، عشت ما بين أهلي وبين خواني، ما حسيت بالغربة أبد والله، عشت ما بين أهلي وبين خواني. تذكر من قلت لك ليش أنا بالذات؟ قال مو أنا، عليك الشيخ وصاني. تذكر من قلت لك ليش أنا بالذات؟ قال مو أنا، عليك الشيخ وصاني. ليش استعجلت يا محمد الترحال بعد بأول وصار العمر فاني، أمير الشعر ينتظرك تجي وتشوف، يا نهر القواف وبحر الأوزاني، لو تدري يا فارس لو تدري يا فارس قبل ما عزيك مثل الناس جاني الشعر عزاني، لو تدري يا فارس قبل ما عزيك مثل الناس جاني الشعر عزاني، محمد كان بيرغ يحدي بالشعار، ومن بين الحداهم قدمت آني، محمد كان بيرغ يحدي بالشعار، ومن بين الحداهم قدمت آني، لجل هذا الوطن قال لنا كل شي يهون، ونحط عيوننا في وسط العياني، بعدنا على الدرب يا صاحبي ماشين، وبعد وعد عقل الوطن لو رأي ينخاني، الله اللي يرحمك يا صاحبي ويجزيك، ويلهمنا صبر نعمة نسياني، يلهمنا صبر نعمة نسياني.
ستفتقدك يا أبو خلف منابر الشعر وساحات المهرجانات.
The poets will miss you, أبو خلف. The festivals will miss you, because the last man who was coping with every new good initiative, a person who was unique in creativity and innovation. Our sole condolence is the steps you left behind, the fingerprints you left behind in every single corner of the Abu Dhabi city. Your achievements are self-expressive and self-explanatory. You was leader and pioneer in the those achievements. We ask God to compensate you and to reward you for those. And now we give the floor to the poets, to the millions of poets in the sixth edition, Saif Ghanim Al-Mansouri. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, may peace be upon his messenger, peace be upon you. Your Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Tahnoun, Your Highness Muhammad bin Sultan, thank you Dr. Jamal Asanada Swidi for this gathering, which gather our hearts in loving the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. Thank you, Your Excellency General Faris Khalaf al-Mazrui.
يقول سكرت
قافي عن جميع المواضيع، والروح ما ياها سعى في وزاها، عقب الغياب اللي بليات وديع اللي يخلي العين تذرف دماها، والصدر كضتها الضلوع الخواشيع حتى تضيق خافقه من وراها. في فقد أخوي، في فقد أخوي اللي يذب المطاليع، كم فرجة من قبل توطى وطاها. يا أبو خلف، يا أبو خلف عزت حروف المواديع، وكم كلمة مطاع يظهر خفاها. فقدك يروع والحزن له تسانيع، ومن لابك فرقاك عينه شكاها. يبكونك شيوخ تضك المجاميع، ودموعها تشرح لنا عن عناها. ويبكونك اللي ذكرهم فالعرب ذيع، وأهل البيوت الطايلات وذراها. ويبكونك أهل الذود في معشب الريع، في خايع الظفرة ومظلم سماها. ويبكونك أهل مقرنسات مفاريع، وتربط طيور القنص ما تباها. ويبكونك الشعار ببيات توديع، كأن الحزن يتلبس اللي قراها. حزنك بحر ما هو بملك المجاريع، كم غارق في بحر حزنك وتاها. حزنك بحر ما هو بملك المجاريع، كم غارق في بحر حزنك وتاها. لكن موتك حق له أمر ونطيع، والنفس بأمر الله تسير تهواها. ولكن ذكرك حي بين المواضيع، وطريق نحيبه قلوبنا دلاها. وبشرك مجلسك طلق المصاريع، يحوي الرجال بضفته ويتباها. وبشرك مجلسك طلق المصاريع، يحوي الرجال بضفته ويتباها. ما دام صوت المرحبة له تشاريع، وعاد الدلال يفوح زاكي شذاها. وبشرك دون الوطن ذكرنا شيع، وارواحنا نبض البلاد وفداها. وصيتك يوم الليالي مرى بعيونكم ستر البلاد وغطاها. وصيتك وبشرك دون الوطن ذكرنا شيع، وارواحنا نبض البلاد وفداها. وصيتك يوم الليالي مرابيع، عيونكم ستر البلاد وغطاها. يلا عسى قبرك رياضة مفاريع، وفي جنة الفردوس روحك مشاها. معاد عقبك نستلذ المواضيع، اللي يتل الأهل القصيد معناها. وسلامتكم.
On your behalf, we welcome His Highness Saif bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the Vice President of the Ministerial Council. The late Muhammad Khalaf Al Mazrui spared no effort to serve the country. It's why his death was shocking to us, was surprising to us. Now, with a poem delivered by the Prince of Poets, Ala Janib, and he is the Prince of Poets of the last edition. Your Highnesses, Your Excellency, the Director, General Director of the Center, ladies and gentlemen, peace be upon you. Whenever I remember the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui, I remember the saying of our Prophet Muhammad, the ones who are closer to me are the ones who have best manners, the ones who are easygoing. And I hope that Muhammad is with our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. My poem the sudden tears and they reflect the shocking news of his death to me.
جري أنينك يا ربابة واجرحي قلبي ولا تترفقي بضلوعي أنا مطفأ العينين من دمع البكاء والحزن يصهرني كدمع شموعي مخطوفة روحي وعقلي ذاهل متحير في صرختي وخشوعي أبكي على تلك المروءة كلها مدفونة في تربة المزروع. أبكي على الشهم الوفي على الذي أخذ الرضا ومضى بغير رجوع. أبكي الفتى العربي زينة ربعه حلو الشمائل صافي الينبوع. أبكي ولكن الدموع تخونني فيطق جمر من مكان دموعي. آهٍ على فقد الرجال، آهٍ على فقد الرجال وفرحة الأنذال في مرسى بغير قلوعي. كاد ابن زايد أن يلين لفقده لولا مقام جنابه المرفوع. ومن الوفاء يبكي الرجال على الرجال بكاء بكاء عين غير ذات خضوع. ويلي على الفندي يفدي خاله بين الوداع ودهشة التفزيع. ويلي على خال يرد عن ابنه لقيا النيا وبشاعة الترويع. كل يفدي بالحياة رفيقه لكن سيف الموت غير مطيع. لو أن كف الموت لو أن كف الموت تقبل فدية لفديت بالموصول والمقطوع. لكن حين المرء نجم دائر فإذا أتاه فليس بالمدفوع. يا جامع الشمل الكريم بمجلس يا جامع الشمل الكريم بمجلس أنت الوحيد به أخي وشفيعي. أنا لا أصدق يا محمد أننا ندعو فنلقى منك غير سميعي. أنا لا أصدق أن شمسك غربت رغما وباتت غير ذات طلوعي. أنا لا أصدق أن أجيئك زائرا وتغيب عن لقياي أو توديعي. والأصدقاء بكل دار صاحب متهدج الأنفاس في الترجيع. كل يكذب ما يقال وقد على دق الطبول بقلبه المخلوع. آه على الرجل الذي لاقيته فلقيته صدرا بغير دروعي. كان الأخ المرجو والظهر الذي يؤوي إليه الناس غير جزوعي. لا تتقي الجارات لا تتقي الجارات ريبة عينه لأمانة الأخلاق غير مضيع. متواضع في ثوبه وحديثه في هيبة جلى بغير خنوع. في رأيه برق الحقيقة خاطف ما بال رأي مثقف موسوع. يا حاملي نعش المسافر مفردا بالله رفقا بالأخ المصروع. امشوا به هونا فإن لأهله قلبا يجف من الأسى المنقوع. يا صبر يعقوب لرحلة يوسف هل تستجيب لقلبي المصدوع. يا أم موسى أين قلبك لامرئ فقد الشقيق وخاطر مفجوع. من مصر من دار الوفاء رثيته وبمصر كم قلب به موجوع. في جنة الفردوس يبنى قلوبنا وإلى جوار الله يا مزروعي. شكرا.
Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui had friendships with a lot of people, either those who studied with him or worked with him or were pioneers in his majlis. A lot of friends would have hoped to talk about him. The speech of the friends of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui will be delivered by Mr. Rashid al-Arimi, the editor the ex-editor in chief of Al Ittihad newspaper. Your Highness Saif bin Zayed Al Nahyan, Your Highnesses, Your Excellency the Director General of the Center, ladies and gentlemen, I try to gather the dispersed ideas to say in this day few words that I think won't give and won't complete reciting and listing the manners and achievements of the late Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. I think that his achievement or witnesses of his giving and his generosity and services to the country. Muhammad was the friend who was working indeed more than words. He was somebody whom you can resort to complain and to seek compassion, and we were always resorting to him when we were in trouble or in grief. I dealt with him as a boss at work and as a friend, and in both cases he was a teacher. He was so determined to achieve his dreams. He was one of the heroes who were driven by the loyalty and sacrifices to the nation. It is difficult to believe that one person managed to leave all this fingerprint in all this field, cultural and intellectual and artistic field. His high determination made him always assuming that the people he was dealing with are capable of doing whatever he assigned to them. He had a very strong energy. He was inspirational to them, and he was always asking them and advising them to work and continue work harder. They discovered in themselves, thanks to Muhammad, lots of skills which they couldn't discover before. He was so generous, and the saying of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, applies to him. The one which says he was very easygoing, and this kind spirit and this kind mind was omnipresent. Even when he disagrees with others, he is always smiling, and he was always welcoming even his opponents. And because of that particular personality and treatment, those opponents turned into fans. He had several stances and positions which will be eternalized by the history of the UAE. I'm looking for that guy who said, I devoted my life and work for the UAE, and I won't leave unless I spread seeds of love and loyalty and faithfulness to this country. Muhammad, peace be upon him, was decorating his majlis with a drawing, very creative, where he compiled the several components of the heritage of the UAE, from valleys, from afflage, from the deserts, from several places in the UAE. And that painting was reflecting his spirit and the way he was thinking and he was perceiving his country and his surroundings. And he was an artist in that painting per se. I'm looking for Muhammad in every single cultural manifestation in Abu Dhabi. He wanted media that is based on solid basis. He was believing in the power of media to uncover the real picture of the United Arab Emirates. I'm looking for the real culture, and I see him flying, enhancing and encouraging culture in the UAE society. He was holding the heritage and culture of the UAE and presenting them to others. His intellect and smartness and revealed the real cultural values and ideals of the UAE in a world where consumerism and materialism is dominating. Dear friend, we miss you with your debt. The UAE as a whole lost a big man, a strong man who contributed to many successes. We lost a model, an exemplary model, and this is proven by the great attendance of people who came to console your family, and all of them were shocked by your sudden disappearance. We'll always walk following your path, and we'll always talk about you as an exemplary model to our children, and we hope that God grants you with mercy. And we are today gathering for you and to encourage each other to follow the path of your likes in terms of loyalty, faithfulness, and in order to console each other. May peace be upon you, Muhammad. Great mercy. And may Allah bestows upon you all his grants, and grant us as well with patience and fortitude. The family of the late Muhammad Khalaf Al-Mazrui were primarily shocked by the death. They found their resort and the condolences in the condolences presented by others that impacted very deeply that. Now, with the speech of the nephew of the late Muhammad Khalaf Al-Mazrui, General Faris Khalaf Al-Mazrui.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Your Highness Saif bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the Vice President of the Ministerial Council, Your Highness Sultan bin Tahnun, Your Highness Mohammed bin Sultan, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, may peace be upon you.
It's very difficult for me to talk about the late Muhammad Khalaf Al-Mazrui. He was every day telling us about the future, the promising future, the joyful future of the UAE. That death was very shocking to us. It was very hard to us. If you listened to what has been said about you during the day when we heard your death, you could have wished to come back to join us. Muhammad Khalaf Al-Mazrui was serving very faithfully and loyally the country, and he was talking to the youth of the UAE, and he was turning that majlis into a workshop, a very interactive workshop in which he discusses all ideas with the youth and the attendees. He had several projects, and he doesn't have limits to his achievements and his dreams. The life of Muhammad was full of achievements, of giving. And he was one of those who devoted and committed themselves and their time for the nation. And that sudden death was very saddening to us. His spirit was very fond of the United Arab Emirates.
He was so attracted to the its heritage and cultural component in the palm day trees, in the scents of the deserts, etc. Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui was believing that all dreams can be achieved, and he was a good companion to all. He didn't spare any effort. He very often had spent nights to work on his project and to see this project concrete. He had noble feelings and that impacted all his surroundings, and we wish that other youth take him as an example, as a model. Muhammad leaves and the nation and our state and country remains with the leadership of the strong leaders of the UAE to serve this nation, to serve the values and ideals of this nation, and to exert all effort to serve the children of this nation. Muhammad leaves and the United Arab Emirates remains the Emirates of Zayed, Khalifa, Muhammad bin Zayed, and all other brothers. The nations remain. Oh Muhammad, your beloved ones are commemorating your memory. We are proud of you, and we are proud that you are part of our family, part of our society. We'll never forget you. We will always miss you, and we wish that you make this big loss alleviated to us and easier to us, because we suffered a lot because of your loss. Ladies and gentlemen, I think that all friends here, all attendees were loving Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui. That represents a cure to our injury, and that reflects how beloved you were to your friends and the nation. May Allah protect all the society of United Arab Emirates, and peace be upon you. At the end of this event, the Emirates Center for Research and Strategic Studies is honored to honor the family of Muhammad Khalaf al-Mazrui in recognition of his efforts and achievement to serve the state and to serve the country. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your participation and for your attendance, which we appreciate, and may Allah grant you His mercy. And we invite you all to our lunch buffet. Thank you.